gentlemen. Welcome to the last time watching on Ninja Warrior Gym. This is, of course, a day 5 of Kalakuri and Liquidania. But die, here we are, man. We've been waiting for this. Kalakuri Twin and Liquidania. These are the anime that you kind of wait to see of how good things go. But die, of course, I'm Kirby. This is Poppy. And this is, of course, Donald Sonic. And guess who's back from the commentary team? That's it, guys. Me and Makomo. Guys, how you guys doing? You guys finally rested up. You guys get caught up with watching the anime with us. And we're glad that you're back in the commentary team. But guys, we kind of wait to see how this anime gonna go. Why I say this? Because I go to the movie, of course, has 6 episodes total. And why I look at them is gonna have an OVA. How a shock went. Again, watching on one episode on Christmas special. So guys, any thought for today's anime I've been watching on?
We did all the game, but now this time you're watching Kalakuri Twin. This is a performance song. We don't know what happened to the backstory. Well, we will see a couple of photos.
We just saw like up from season 1, almost the end of the episode, how crazy this was. Wanda, she, I forgot what her name, but she just ripped her nail, like, oh my lord. Yeah, but guys, we know said because these, of course, the Kalakuri Twin, we're going to want Kalakuri Twin. Kalakuri season 2 will be on, of course, on the work for the day to announce. And, well, that kind of way, because you guys also, you do kind of miss the new version. However, Manager Dog will be coming on Monday to improve the new version with due to some dates that have to perform. Guys, that we know that Sonic has a show with this because health is important and on what you guys do. Make sure you're with one of your loved ones or so you know if not feeling well or whatever. But you always have to make sure that health is matter in your own work, even in your own life. So guys, well guys, enough chit chat, because let's play a game where shit is gonna be a whole another level of Kalakuri Twin.
I got your dad, but here we are. We're going to watch, of course, Kalakuri Twin, which we see a lot of faces. So, like I was saying, this is a backstory. Okay, they go to the giveaway. I'm just talking about here. But I'm going to tell you, we're going to watch a Tyler Trent.
Yes, this is the video.
Cacao Private Academy. Known for its prestige and traditions, this school is about to celebrate its 121st anniversary. A hierarchy exists within the ranks of its elite students. It's not your grades or how you do in sports that will get you noticed here. That would be...
A week later, there's Mary.
I'm not making any friends. Why not? Everyone was watching me when I played against Ayura. I made sure to study and have answered everything in class perfectly so no one could make fun of me. My makeup is natural and freaking awesome. My nails are a conservative pastel pink. And I've been making sure to be extra nice. Damn it. I don't have much hope for my life plan at this point. When people are born, they naturally tend to fall into hierarchies. Endurance, intelligence, appearance, sensibility, and don't forget money. I hate how society divides people up into winners and losers based on circumstances we can't control. That's why I decided to transfer to the school as an honor student. By the time I leave this school, I'll be a winner. Although, at this rate, I'm not so sure anymore. Oh, hi, Mary. How was school been? Are you getting used to it? Yeah, I guess. Did you need something, Hanate Mari? Oh, well, I was hoping, and I know that this is kind of out of the blue, but would you like to? Would you want to? Could we please be friends? Sure, I guess. I guess that was presumptuous. I'm sure you already have a bunch of friends. And you might not like me anyway. I'm slow. I'll probably just end up being a house pet forever. Never mind. It's fine. Forget I even asked. What's that pathetic look on your face? You did this when I was up against Ayura, too. Why do you have this? Aren't you supposed to be a house pet? If you have this kind of money, why don't you use it for yourself? Even if I could get out of being a house pet, it wouldn't be for long. And I wouldn't know what to do with myself if I did. Why are you always like this?
That's Marge.
I'm sorry.
The sink? And so that so people will hear him siren.
I'm not Tamari.
That's cool.
Would you mind explaining something to me? Well, really, I think it's just because that wasn't a whole lot of money.
Really?
To the kids at this school, $200,000 is allowance money, something to buy school supplies with. I don't think it would be really enough to prove that you're a good gambler. You'd probably have to play with higher stakes than that.
Wow, I guess this school really is that ridiculous.
Oh, I forgot to ask earlier. What are you drinking?
Huh? Let me show you. I have one of these.
Oh, that is so cute!
I've been carrying this thing around since middle school.
I can't remember the last time I saw a water bottle.
Oh.
Is that why they've been looking down on me? So, after school, there are gambling dens that pop up, right? Would you mind showing me around?
Yes, of course! Which one of them did you want to visit?
Well, I was thinking. Why don't we pop into whichever one is the least popular?
Oh boy.
Are you sure this is gonna be okay?
This'll be fine.
Mary?
If this spot isn't totally dead, it'll be that much easier for me to take it over.
Huh?
I think I figured out the secret to being a winner. And it's to be the financier of a den. Just watch. Fastest way to the top. This is
the- And we're back.
Excuse me. Anyone here?
Really?
Oh, hi, welcome. So sorry I didn't notice you come in at all.
Oh.
Are you all right?
Oh.
Welcome to the literary club. I'm the president, Yukini Togakushi. Were you two thinking about becoming members today?
The president?
Yeah, I thought so. It's embarrassing to admit, but it's always pretty dead in here. We don't really get patrons. I'm the only club member that hasn't ghosted yet.
Perfect. Now to figure out how to pull it off.
Oh, how lucky for me. Visitors.
Oh my god, you remember?
Yeah, sorry, we're a little busy.
Send them out.
No, not her. She's different.
Oh god.
Right. As of this present reading, the club's access to this room is revoked. You can no longer use this space. So please vacate immediately.
What?
Huh? I can't just do that right away. There's...
When did you last pay usage fees for this room? Surely you got our collection letters. Who is she? I don't like how she came in here.
Right, you're new. She's the chair of the Student Council Public Morals Committee, Sachiko Turaku. The gambling dens here are under her jurisdiction.
What's the matter, Yukini?
What do you think about letting me use this place?
Huh?
You? Let me take over running this den for you. I'll improve the revenue stream, and I'll even pay a higher usage fee.
Interesting. And who are you?
First year Hana class, Mary Sautome.
Can we slow down for a second? I can pay you back next month, even what's overdue.
I think it would be better to go with someone brand new instead of placing the same losing bet on a person that has failed you.
How fascinating. Let's do this then. Mary, Yukini, you will gamble. The winner will control this den.
I was optimistic, but there was no way I could have imagined things falling into place like this.
All right, the minimum buy-in will be 1,000,000 yen.
Oh,
it's the same amount as a gambling den setup fee. I wouldn't worry.
That's
the
a lot.
Loser pays, so you owe me nothing if you win.
That's so much money.
Yes, I'll do it.
It's not like I have a choice.
Oh, crap.
What's the matter, Mary? How much can you put down?
I only have... 200,000.
Fine, I will front the money for the bet. If you lose, then I'll expect my 800,000.
Don't do it, Mary! You don't want to owe the student council money!
But you do want the den right. You should be willing to accept the risk.
I'm not Tamari. I have to prove myself somewhere.
Fine then. I'll help. I'll front 500,000. I want to.
You do?
700.
Oh boy.
Very well. Mikura, start us off. Yes.
Oh no.
Aww.
The game we'll be playing today is known as Three Hit Dice. As the dealer, I will toss the dice. It's a simple concept to understand. The goal is to guess what numbers on the dice will be rolled. The dice shall read as follows. 1, 2, and 3 will be down. 4, 5, and 6 will be designated as up. As for you two, I'll have each of you guess the result of each roll before they occur. Whichever of you to correctly call a sequence combination will be the winner. For example, let's say our match is A versus B. A guesses U, D, D. And B guesses D, U, D. Then the dealer will throw the dice. A's guess of U, D, D appears first in this scenario, which means A would be the winner. Please write down your guesses. Then pass your cards to me and I will roll.
Sorry about this, but I need to keep protecting this gambling den. I'm going to win this.
If I win, the gambling den is mine. If I lose, I owe a lot of money. It'll be hard to get out of debt once I have it. I'll probably end up becoming a house pet. I don't have a choice. I have to win. I will win. The cards are in, and the game will begin now. Here's the first toss.
Here we go.
The first toss is down. If she wrote down the same guess as Togakushi, then the match would be a draw right now. Second toss, down. But other than that, well, the likelihood of the die throw landing in an up or down position is the same at 1 in 2 chances. With these 3 consecutive tosses, the probability would be cubed. That would put it at a 1 in 8 chance. Third toss now.
There we go.
Your odds of winning are the same. Sure, if you fall into the typical traps. It's a big mistake to think that way. If we were just tossing the dice and guessing individual results, then the probability for any combination is the same. But guessing which combination is going to come up first is totally different. There are always going to be combinations that end up being more probable than others. This is what's commonly known as a gambler's fallacy. UUD, UDD, DDU, DUU. That's all possible combinations of letters where the result appears twice in a row after just 8 tosses. So for us to have a result with 3 down or up rolls in a row, we'd have to expect that as the estimated value of 14 tosses. The thrill at the core of dice games stems from the slight fluctuations in probability. A small difference can lead to big results. Fifth toss is down. With all that being said, my guess was UUD.
Yes.
It's the most probable pattern.
Okay.
I'd be surprised if she didn't know that too.
Two offs, so one down.
Sixth toss.
One.
This is really just a countermeasure, so I won't be at a disadvantage. I've done everything I can. Whatever may happen after this is for fate to decide. The seventh toss.
Wait, no.
Up. This means the game is over.
What?
D-U-U was rolled. Miss Togakushi is the winner.
No way! How could Mary have lost?
Then as we agreed, Yukimi will retain den rights. And I believe I'm owed 1,000,000 yen from... Mary.
No way.
You don't look too happy. I thought you'd be a more gracious winner, Yukimi.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Right. I won. So that means I can keep using this space for the club, right?
Of course it does. Do you have any objections to that?
No. I'm so relieved. Mary.
One more round. Let's play one more round.
One more. For the money.
Privilege to argue.
No, I don't.
However, let's raise the stakes for the next round. Mikura.
Yes.
Aww.
What's this?
I'm laying out this collar for you. You'll become my personal house pet if you lose.
You're kind of cold.
You'll be sent to fetch things for me. If I tell you to keep watching, not fall asleep. And...
If I tell you to end your life, you will die.
Oh, God. Mary, can I live? Oh, my God.
Dude, I'm shaking.
Dude, I tremble.
Okay.
So, what'll it be, Mary? Are you certain you're ready for that potential outcome?
Mary, can I live?
Yes, I'm in. Think about this. All of this is entirely up to chance. I just lost, so I'm sure I can win this time.
Oh, shit. Not good.
All right, then. The game is 3 hit dice. This round will be the one that decides the winner. Please write your guesses and pass them here.
That's what we got.
Just like season one, there's no talking out loud. I mean, this we haven't talked a lot because it's a focus.
Mistress Jiraku only wants to control Sao Tome. If I want to be a good pet, I have to make sure she loses. Here's mine.
So she made sure that she gonna lose. All right.
She checked the card.
Thank you for submitting your cards. Now for the first toss.
So 7, 13.
Up.
Alright.
Second toss. Down. There's a deeper level of trickiness to the traps already set by this game. While it's true that these 4 combinations have a higher probability of appearing first, that doesn't make it any easier for the gambler to win. Like rock, paper, scissors, there's a certain compatibility that makes winning possible. For example, UUD could be your winning combination, but it would lose against DUU. In this scenario, DUU would have a 2-in-3 chance of winning you the match. This is a phenomenon where DUU has a higher probability of appearing right before UUD. The same truth could then be applied to all resulting combinations. Which means making sure Sao Tome loses is very simple. Being the dealer means I can look at Sao Tome's card, and then change Togakushi's card with one that will put her at an advantage. In this round, Sao Tome wrote down UUU as her guess. So I changed Togakushi's card to DUU, which has a higher probability of winning. Sao Tome's odds of winning were only 12.5%. But those odds all but disappeared when the second toss was down. Third toss.
Bitch!
Down.
That's cheating.
At this rate, Sao Tome's loss is just a matter of time.
Wow,
and fourth toss. You stupid little girl. You have no chance of winning. All you can do is pray for a win. What do you think of me now, Mistress Jiraku? I'm not like all the other little girls in the school with no brain and no follow-through. All I've ever wanted is for you to use me.
Oh.
Hey! Careful, you've got the cards wet! Sorry about that. You're just as slow and stupid as you look. Mistress Jiraku will get bored of you very quickly. All right, we'll resume the game at the fifth toss.
Oh, there's no need for that.
Huh?
I have DDU. That's what I wrote down.
Huh?
Shouldn't the dealer have already known that? I wrote DDU on the card before I gave it to you.
I don't know what you're talking about. That wasn't what I saw.
DDU! That means Mary wins!
What did you do? How did you change what you wrote?
What, did you think I wouldn't figure it out? This game is basically rock, paper, scissors. Take the first round. I noticed Togakushi's hand was a combination that had an inherent advantage over mine, so I started to wonder. You pretty much confirmed my thoughts in the second game. Despite the fact that she was the winner, Togakushi was still pretty hesitant to accept it. Which leads me to believe that you swapped her card without her knowing. Being able to change up the player's cards puts you in a pretty sweet position, wouldn't you say? It's like throwing paper after they throw rock.
This doesn't make any sense! Your card had UUU, I saw! You changed it, how?
I drew the vertical line in D with this. If you can change your answer, then I should be able to spot mine out.
What is that?
Nail polish remover with acetone is usually clear whenever you paint it on your nails or paper. But if you add water, it magically becomes darker than its surrounding colors. So, that's when it shows up on the card as right. Thank you so much! Because of your tells, it was so much easier for me to win! I only had a 50-50 chance otherwise! I never would have made that second bet without knowing you were a cheat!
Let's go!
Well done, ladies. No one said that you had to use a black pen to write your guess. Even though it was done in nail polish remover, you did write DDU on your card. If UUU had paid off, you would have kept quiet and accepted the win. Is that right? Your first bet set your chances of losing at 87.5%. With the little acetone trick you pulled, you were able to pivot that into a 71% likelihood of winning. That deserves applause. Even with that guarantee, you still had a 29% chance of losing. This bet made you put your life on the line. Or did you think I was bluffing when I proposed the results?
No. Isn't that what the core of gambling's all about? I mean, I had a 71% chance of winning. I'd be stupid not to play with those odds. If you aren't willing to take on some amount of risk, then you'll never have the opportunity to win. If losing is the only result when I walk away, then the only way to win is by play.
How illuminating. It's settled. Congratulations to you. This gambling den is now Mary's.
Good shot.
What's gonna happen to good the Literary Club?
Give it up. You knew you had lost the first round, but didn't argue when Mikura declared you the winner. You played along. You have no right to protest this outcome.
Oh, cry me a river. My guy, Mary won. That's it for the first episode of Category Squared, where of course we saw Mary, you know, and also she won the first game. But guys, next episode, we're going to watch episode 2 of Category Twin.
And then we're doing non-stop.
Yeah, and guys, Also, after we're done with Kaiju Return, we will have some breaking news for season two.
All right.
All right, let's go, guys.
All right, next agenda item. We've been having recurring problems with one of the students. She just came into the school this year. Midari Ikishima.
Yes.
Over the last month, people have begun calling her the Destroyer of Dens. She's well earned this nickname by gambling at several locations across campus and has ousted leaders at seven of them. Five of them were previously under student council jurisdiction. None of the usage fees for the dens have been paid, and she's made no indication she intends to pay.
Sayaka, I'll leave this to you.
I've made the arrangements. Miharutaki. Understood. I'll get it done today.
Sachiko, you're in a good mood today.
That's because I am.
I'm sure you are.
Interesting first years.
Mary.
Oh, guy.
Mary.
Oh, hey, Suzera. Good morning.
Joint Council of the President.
Yeah, we've seen since the one back in summer.
But not her. She's new.
We have a gambling den. I was so excited, I don't think I slept at all last night.
Are you sure you're really a high schooler? Everyone here acts so freaking weird. What? You okay?
Oh! What the razor blade doing here?
Are those razors? Who put those there?
There's nothing I can do. You know, I'm a mitten.
It'll be okay. Each step will bring me closer to being a winner. I can handle anything if it's temporary. I'm not gonna lose now.
No way.
And we're back.
Huh? Oh, good morning, you two.
Oh, what the hell?
I cleaned up. Yukimi Togakushi, what do you think you're doing in my den? Simple. I'm the club president. And I still have the key.
I didn't ask how you got in.
What, are you trying to take the den back?
I swear I'm not. Nothing like that. I just want to keep using this room for my club, that's all. None of the members ever show up here, so the club won't interfere with gambling. Can I please? I'll even hide.
Oh, come on, Mary. I think it'll be good.
Huh?
Until yesterday, Togakushi was the one running the gambling den. Don't you think she might have some good suggestions for us?
Yeah, nobody cared about it. Why would I want to listen to her ideas?
I guess. She did just lose all her space. I think that must be pretty hard.
Forget about her. You should put yourself first. Did you forget that you...
Challenging thing about running a gambling den would definitely be the money. I picked library prep room number 2 because it was one of the cheapest options, but the fee I owe the student council is still 500,000 yen a month.
Pretty pricey.
And the fee for 2 people is even higher than that. You would need to donate at least 700,000 yen a month. Then you gotta include the amount necessary to change up Hanatemari's status.
Oh, about that. I heard there's an easier way to reverse a house pet status. Easier than waiting for a donation day. Isn't there an exception with student council if you donate 1,000,000 yen? If I'm being honest, I didn't really think aiming for that would be realistic, but... I don't feel like that anymore. So if we take all of that into account, it's 1.7 mil. I need to make this amount in the fastest way possible.
You really think we can do that?
Of course we can! Mary can do it. I know my prince can do anything!
One question. Do we know what game we'll play?
Of course. I've already figured that out.
Second game. What's this?
We'll use this.
A number this time.
Whoa. What the?
Yeah, it's like a party going on.
Oh, oh, it's her.
Oh, yeah.
Pardon me, ladies.
What's up, you bitch? You know I'm here. Sakura Miharutaki, Beautification Council. Huh? Don't play dumb, Den Destroyer Ikishima.
What, you got a problem with me gambling on campus?
That is not what I have an issue with. You've taken over 7 dens. You're the one with the usage rights. But that ownership transfer saddled you with the usage fees for those dens. The student council is renting you those dens, and we are here to collect. You owe us 5 million yen. Payment is due today, and we expect the amount in full.
5 million yen? 5 million yen, wow.
She owned 5 million yen.
What's so funny?
Aren't you stupid? No one in this room has that kind of money.
He took our money and shoved it up Mickey's ass.
That's enough. What? We have to. We
I'm fucking drinking.
Threaten us as much as you want. It won't come back. Search them.
Oh, wow.
You can't touch my stuff. We are busy with administrative duties. I suggest you comply. And I'll remind you, the Beautification Council has the authority to arrest students. But you can't do that to me.
Chill out for a second. Isn't anyone else bored to tears by arguing about stupid crap like this? Why don't we gamble instead?
Go on.
Well, it sounds like we both want to solve this problem as quickly as possible, am I right? Lucky for us, this place has so many games. I'll even let you pick which one.
Not joking.
Oh,
the Famicom.
Oh wow.
But look, every game.
I want a dice game.
A dice game.
This will be make it or break it. Guess if the upcoming dice roll will be even or odd. Will that be simple enough for you? Yeah. Then hurry up and throw. Now, you throw the dice. I'll be the one to make the guess.
Lamb, are you sure that's a good idea? If she's the one with the dice, who knows what trick she'll try to pull?
My word is final. Toss the dice, Minari Ikishima.
Oh, good! I don't know what you've got up your sleeve, but I want to see!
What's that guy doing?
Even Rod. It's even.
Hesitate. You carry yourself confidently. You're a woman that knows what she wants. Let's get this over with. I want to see what you rolled.
Oh, fine. You're no fun.
All right, time for the big reveal. Here it is.
Six.
It's even. The council chief wins.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Looks like she got it right.
Hey, fine. There's 5 million. What compelled you to choose even? Did you go with a feeling? You already know the answer, so why ask me? Make sure it's all there.
Well, we were kind of wondering too.
Simple. I saw through their trick. Then I turned it back around on them.
They tricked us?
Yes. Ikishima likely predicted that we would play a dice game from the beginning.
But how could she have possibly known which game we would choose to play?
It was a matter of logic. The room was staged for me to pick that game. Take a look around us. There's shogi, go, chess, checkers, mahjong, backgammon, and a collection of video games. All those options take time. I said I was in a hurry, so of course I'd pick whichever was the fastest. They left me with two options, cards or dice. Unfortunately, these are exceptionally easy to cheat with. But there's no helping that. So I was forced to choose between the two.
Oh, I see now.
So what made you choose the dice then?
I'll not pick a game that I know I can't win. When I picked up the die earlier, I couldn't help but notice that the two side was a little heavier. That's why I wanted you to toss the dice, and I would be the one to guess the roll.
She didn't need to throw the dice to figure it out.
I'm still confused about all this. If the 2 side was down, it would have shown a 5. But when she rolled, it turned over as a 6.
Ikishima wanted to make it obvious to me that she had added weight to the die. Because then she'd swap out the loaded one. 5. Which means the new way to die in the game would be rigged to throw evens. The rest was easy. All that's left is 2, 4, and 6. That's it. Logically, there was no way for me to lose.
Well, she came up with offense and defense right away.
She's so amazing. My business is done here. I have other collections. Well, that was sick. Don't be a sore loser.
Score all
out. Here, I've got 30 million. Please go another round.
30 million?
Let's play again.
Why would she play? Especially when she caught your weighted dice in the first game.
Yeah, I thought you might bring that up again. So this time I promise I'll be a good girl and I won't touch the dice at all. Okay. And I'll even let you be the one to make the guess. What do you think?
She go all out.
What are you scheming? We know the dice are going to roll even.
So that means there's no reason not to play.
It's like finding free money out on the street.
Come on, hurry up and play with me, Sakura Miharutaki. Don't you want 30 million yen?
Not really. You probably switched out the die again right after the game just when you thought no one was looking. Or you haven't and you just want to convince everyone you did. Mind games aren't very interesting for me to play, so I'm not going to.
Damn.
What was her deal? She had totally negative vibes. She didn't know what she was talking about.
Sure. Miharutaki did get one thing wrong about the match. I didn't touch the dice after the game finished. She was reading into things too much. She assumed that I swapped one loaded die with another, which made her choose even. But she was wrong. The die that I ended up swapping in was completely legit. It just so happened to roll an even number. She'll get nowhere with that talent if she stays so straight and narrow. She's gotta learn to be flexible or she'll break.
Well, you can't think of a single person who can break the president of the Beautification Council.
At least not yet.
That was incredible, right?
Yeah.
It was a heck of a comeback.
So is this a new gambling den?
You want to check it out?
Welcome, children! You found the literary club!
Oh my god!
Whoa, she's beautiful, pretty!
Whoa! Alright, good sir. Let me explain the rules of the game and then we can play. It's all pretty simple. We'll be using these 3 dice today. First, we let our customers select one of these options, and then they give it a toss onto the table. The dealer picks a different dice to throw and compares the results. Whoever has the higher number wins.
I guess that seems pretty straightforward. But these don't look like regular dice.
Yes, these are custom-made, so the faces are unique. The black dice has 3, 4, and 8. The white dice has 1, 5, and 9. The red dice has 2, 6, and 7.
So some of these dice are weaker than others. You're sure there's not some sort of trick to these things?
Of course not. Feel free to examine them to your heart's content.
Cool. Guess I'll try it out.
So legit.
Not to rain on the fun, but I'd like to point out that our den's current policy has a gambling limit of 3 times per day. We're running a special event, so we want to make sure everyone who visits gets a chance to enjoy themselves.
Oh, is that what that means? Can my first bet be 10,000 yen?
That'll be great. Now, please choose your dice, if you wouldn't mind.
I'll go with this one. Okay. Did that one call to you? Well, if I want to win, I need to roll a 9. Should be easy.
Wonderful. I'll pick the red dice for the first round today. Okay, make sure we toss them out at the same time. On the count of 3, 1, 2, 3.
A 3-round limit?
We gotta preserve the magic. We don't want to make them do the same thing every time. That's why I plan to change the game we offer to play on a weekly basis.
Isn't that a waste of time if we're already making a profit?
Why change it? Easy. Someone might figure us out.
Damn, she got a higher.
This. One more time.
Great. Which die would you like this time?
Picking red.
I think the dealer chose this one for a reason.
I guess I'll go with the black dice this time around. My Are you ready? Let's roll!
Alright, you got a high end.
Congratulations on your win!
I totally knew there was something up with the red die.
Everything's playing out just like Mary said. This is a good game for us to start with. It's random, so we'll probably lose a few. But they'll come back for more. Because they're also able to win a few games. This is your last round today. What would you like to do?
I gotta bet again. 50,000. And I'm gonna stick with red.
Alright, I'll keep things simple and use the black dice. Here we go.
Get ready, guy. Damn.
So, how'd we do? Day one revenue. A total of 300,000 yen.
Yeah.
With the seed money, we have 1 million yen. That means 1.7 million is well within our reach. I'm going to make Scizora a human again. I can get the money for that easily.
I didn't think we could make this much right away.
I knew we would bring in some, but not this much.
The maid outfit was a nice touch, right?
Yeah, I thought you were crazy with that idea at first, but in the end it really paid off.
That might have helped, but you picked the perfect game to play. People were eating it up. It was such a good idea.
You are so right. Mary is the best. Praise me all you want.
She's the best.
It won't get you anywhere.
Mary, Mary.
And I guess I would say, shut up, try to sleep.
Oh,
yes, I love her, man.
She's so cute.
How are you always so good at video games?
Don't let the cuteness fool
you.
Too bad you can't get good at growing.
Shut up! I just measured and was like 2 millimeters tall!
You two are having fun.
Hey, Sachi! What's up?
Her name is Sachi.
Play again!
Alright, but I'm definitely winning.
Oh, I found a first year that might be fun for you to play with.
Who? Not the Den Destroyer.
No. This one took library prepper number 2 for me earlier today. Apparently, her new gambling den is open for business. Why don't you go over and check it out?
You better watch out! They're going in for a counter! And another special! Oh, what's up?
Yay. Sorry, Luna. I got something to do.
What?
Hey, Luna.
Learning games aren't fun when I play by
I won't play with her.
Want me to send Kaede over here?
Yeah, Kaede money is no fun. You know he won't play games with me.
I'll come back and play with you later.
Oh, there
How long did Satoru say it was gonna take?
Probably another hour. It was tough to finish your transfer.
Alrighty. So, what do you think? Should we open?
I think it's time.
You're excited about this.
Yeah, Mary's helped me a lot. I want to be able to start paying her back for all she's done.
Hi!
Come on in!
Mary.
Sorry, that took longer than I thought. So, what's going on here?
Oh, hey, Satomi.
What's the matter? Are we losing already?
No, we're up. By 3 million.
Three million?
See him? That's a whiny baloney from the student council.
Shit.
Just kind of showed up.
I'll bet a million. You can afford to pay that amount even if you do lose, right? You know, I bet I'll lose anyway. This game is hard to play.
Okay, let's play. You can play up to 3 rounds a day.
Only 3 tries, huh? I want to play with the white die.
Okay, then. I'll choose the red dice this round.
Seven.
Yeah. Second round.
2 million, please.
Oh. Anatemari won the second match, too. This next one will be the final one he's allowed to play before he hits the limit.
Oh.
4 million this time.
Oh. 4 million? Hey, Mary?
Oh, so you're Mary Saotome. You know, I came all the way here for you. I heard you took out Jiraku in a game yesterday. That's pretty impressive. It looks like you put a lot of thought into this game, too. It's clever that you have the customer be the first one to pick out the die. They take the lead, makes them feel like the playing field is actually even. But you and I both know that isn't true. It's a simple three-way deadlock. Red beats white beats black, and black beats red. When they're pairs, it's a lot easier to win. But with that said, whoever chooses later will win.
He's kidding. Is he serious?
Huh? The probability says there's a 5 in 9 chance. The more times they get you to play, the more the gambling den takes. It's a pretty sweet deal, taking advantage of your customers like that.
Playing with figuring it out.
The day is wasting. I could talk about this for hours. But why don't we gamble and test my theory? I'm gonna choose the white die again. You'll pick red, right?
This is the Martingale system. Every time he loses, he'll double his previous bet. It doesn't matter how many times he loses. He just needs to win once to earn back everything he bet before. I've not come across this method very often, mostly because of the risk. But if this guy came in here to destroy us, this would be the most effective way of doing it. Because if you somehow happen to lose the first two rounds, your chances of winning the third have spiked to 90%.
Fuck!
To predict this and figure out a plan. I'd already lost.
Mr. Mari! Okay?
Nothing will be left.
No way.
Here's what we owe you. 1,000,000 yen.
You can keep it. Let's call it a present.
Huh?
I figure you'll be in trouble if you lose this, especially if you want to reverse your mint status.
You're right, but I still don't...
But if I do that, you think you could help me with something? Mary, I really need you right now. It's not something that's difficult. I just need your help with one thing.
What? Oh, wow.
Destroying the student council president.
Show what? The student counseling. Her.
Oh my. No way.
Destroy the council president?
Yeah.
I don't understand what you mean. Why would you want to hurt her if you're on the council?
A lot of it going on since that changes.
This
is the one?
Don't you think this is a little much? They treat you like an animal just for losing a game. It's wrong. The student council president created this system. I want to dismantle it. If you're willing to help me out, then I'll give you this 1,000,000 back. I know we can do it, Mary. I just need your help.
Use. I don't have the headspace for this.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, what's it?
It's that time of year. Oh, crap. Do I have anything saved up?
Oh, shit.
Hey, do you know what this is?
What? You can't read? It's announcing the due date for student council donations.
Oh, right. So...
If you don't pay up, you'll be a house pet. You better be careful.
This is bad. I don't have any cash right now. I won't be able to help Scissor at all if I'm the one that ends up... And if I'm a house pet too, then neither of us would have any hope of becoming human until we graduate.
Oh, fuck. Amy Bauer, this is bad. This is bad. This is bad. This is so fucking bad, bro.
Shadow Bunny.
Come in.
There he is.
I had a feeling you'd show up right about now.
What are you two doing in here?
What?
I invited them here. Huh? You came all this way, so I assume what I said was a little intriguing to you.
I haven't decided if I want to accept your offer.
That's totally fine. For a long time, the power of the student council has gone completely unchecked. No one has any ability to confront them. And it's all because of this tiered system they made. The threat of becoming a house pet is enough for students to lose any motivation to rise against the student council. They get comfortable with the way things are, which only encourages them to maintain the status quo. Gotta admit, they really thought it through. People get to be petty, and the student council stays comfy. So, what do we do about it? I say we destroy the system.
Everybody had their collar.
Is everyone in Hera?
Yes, they're all house pets. Why get a bunch of them together to do this? We picked out the ones that were higher in rankings. House pets are not typically able to donate 100,000 yen, but if it's 10,000 yen, that's much more doable. 10,000 yen from 100 people? Huh, that adds up to 1,000,000 yen.
So you?
We can weed out the strongest contenders, have them play higher stakes games, collect the winnings, and buy everyone out of being a house pet. This is how we can destroy the system before we take on the student council president. Enough talk. I want to play a game. There's a certain one I think you'll like. This particular one requires multiple people to participate. That's why I asked a couple of your friends to tag along. If you end up winning, you walk away with 1,000,000 yen. Consider it a gift from me to you. Please, Mary. Please help me save them.
Crazy.
Hey, thank you very much. I'm happy to say you can stop crying. Welcome to the 50th annual cobbling party. There have been over 5,000 participants thus far. Many of our happy little lambs made together and got married after graduating. I wonder what kind of drama we can expect from the couples coming up for our 50th year. Best of luck trying to find the one up there tonight, everybody.
What the hell is going on? How is this going to destroy the student council? Is this guy messing with me?
Ladies will confess their love to a special someone. Gentlemen will choose their special someone. I should add, getting coupled up is only for the purposes of the game, so please have fun and don't be creepy. Just relax and enjoy the ride. But as long as your heart is open, there have been countless times that something here has grown into something more. It's okay to have some expectations. Alright, listen up. Sort yourselves out. We need girls and boys on teams of 5. Once you find your team, we'll move on to...
Step 1.
Conversation time. Deepen your friendship and try to find your special someone. Next is...
Step 2.
Consultation. Talk to your team and decide who you want to pick. Finally...
Step 3.
Confession time! One of the ladies will select someone on the men's team to confess their love to. The men will choose whose confession they will accept. Once everyone's filled out their cards, the ladies will announce who they confess their love for. We'll do this in order. For those who are lucky enough to become a couple, the man is the winner. The lady takes the man the amount they bet to play. The men who don't have a partner at the end will lose. They will pay the amount they bet to the ladies. Lady declares any of these prior that obligation after they lose in exchange for a large reduction of their wager. For the fellas out there, the risk involved may come with some big rewards. You'll only have one chance to confess your love and choose that person. Let's get excited to find love, everybody!
Does high school seriously have parties to hook up a bunch of straight kids?
But if we don't go along with this, what would we do?
Hello, Mary Saotome.
you're Mikura.
Yeah,
you're here?
Call me Sato, please.
2 times ago.
So what brings you to this? Finding a boyfriend? Of course not. Disgusting. Huh? My only purpose here is business. Look. Mistress Chiraku is the head manager for this party. I'm here to assist her in its flawless execution.
Great! She's here?
You think we should have Mary Saotome participate in the coupling game?
Yeah.
That isn't what we discussed. I thought you were going to incorporate her into your plans. I feel like you're trying to sneak into my territory. And if you are, I'll eat you.
Understood.
Did you wait? Oh man, sure me.
Back to business. You came as a group of three?
Oh, yeah.
Then I'll introduce you to two more players.
You want the two of us to hop on their team?
Yes.
What's up? Second year from Sakura class. Karumi Karumi. I'm excited to play. Third year from the Botan class. Chitose Inui. It's so great to meet you guys.
Yeah.
Kibashira. Nice to meet you.
I'm Renkoji.
I'm Mamoru Kuonji.
All these guys seem to be ridiculously good-looking. Why would any of them want to be here?
I'm Kanade Musubi. Happy to be here.
Although I guess there's one exception.
Your turn, ladies.
Okay. I'm Chitose Inui. I'm here to find a boyfriend that can treat me like a princess. I'm excited about maybe finding the one this time.
It's better for us if they don't know our goal is to make money. She's doing a great job of fooling them.
Oh, gosh.
She is fooling them, right?
Yeah, hopefully.
Wow. So the three of you really run a gambling den. Doing something like that's a lot of hard work.
Well, yeah. It would be if we were open right now.
So what kind of guy are you into? I'm sure you like dudes that are really smart.
No, not really.
Lucky. So what is your type, then?
Someone who is
so honest that they're stupid. If I'm picking one.
Why did I answer that honestly?
Hey, Hanatemari! You've been sitting real quiet ever since we started. Don't hold back because you're a pet. Tell me about your hobbies.
Well, I guess I like to cook. And needlework I'll do sometimes. But I also like to...
Cooking and needlework? Incredible! You're a prime example of femininity. You're exactly my type. This is amazing.
All right, lovers, time is up.
Okay.
Did you find anybody out there that you might like? Let's move on to consultation.
All right, step two.
How does the betting work? I don't remember her explaining that during the rules.
Hmm?
It was on the registration form. Oh, we had a direct invite. It's 1 million yen per round.
Bitch.
It's too expensive. Damn it. I see what game he's playing now. He's testing me to see if I can handle this. If I'm not experienced enough to get through this, he'll just toss me to the side.
That means we'll probably need to offer the dinner date benefit.
Why don't we try using the sleepover?
All of us
will end up saving some money. We could try and have them in the same room. Doesn't that sound fun? Do you not know what that means?
Hanatemari. A sleepover is when you go to a guy's house and they...
Did she seriously have no idea? Now that we've shot that down, we can go ahead and offer the dinner date to lower our wagers.
Oh, she's moved back.
As for the specifics of our plan, we'll prevent as many couples as possible to win. Otherwise, we'll end up owing. To ensure this, everyone should confess to someone different. If all of us confess to the same guy, it increases our chances of coupling up. Suzura should definitely not be confessing to Musubi.
Yeah, he seemed to take quite a liking to her.
Oh, could it be Kumonji to confess to?
Hmm? Why?
Did you see how hot his glasses made him look? Sure, he might not have talked a lot, but I love the quiet types. Then I'll fill this out for everyone else. Just make these picks, all right? Any objections?
No objections.
Great, let's go. Consultation time is almost over. Please start making your way back to your seats.
Oh.
Suzura, don't let any of the others know, but let's switch our confessions up.
Huh? Why, Mary?
I'm just being extra careful. There's a pretty big flaw in this plan. It's a countermeasure. If there's one traitor among us, there's a danger that we'll all lose. If someone tips off the guys about who is confessing to whom, we're all done for.
I understand, but Togakushi...
I'm sorry, but I don't trust her yet.
Really?
Suzura, now is not the time for us to be hesitating. We need to walk away from this as winners. You hear me?
Okay.
Confession time!
Be attending the needs of your table for tonight. I'm Sato. Thank you for joining us. It's her again. Ladies, please circle the number of the person you would like to confess to and pass it to me. Gentlemen, please take these 5 cards. The numbers are the same as your lineup card. I will collect these after each confession. Would anyone like to declare a benefit?
Yeah, I'd like the dinner date.
I'd like to do that too, please. Me too. Your choices are noted. Please begin your confessions.
I'd like you to start us off. Which of you is it gonna be?
Seems like no problems yet. If we played normally, we'd have to expect at least one couple to form from this. Even if we did have a traitor that told the guys who we were gonna confess to, Suzura and I would still win.
Gentlemen, it's your turn. Please indicate on a card the lady you would like to select.
I'm worried. I'm worried.
I don't think I'm into girls that wear a lot of makeup, you know?
I feel like something is off, but I don't know why.
Yay, my turn! Hey, Kibashira, I like you. Wanna go on a date with me?
I'm just kidding!
Uh-oh, my joke flopped.
Wow, none of them picked her? Why didn't any of those guys react at all? Alright, next person, please.
Oh, right! I pick Musubi.
Next lady, please.
Okay. I'm picking Sarah.
Huh? No, not me. Why'd you say?
we were getting along great!
That wasn't who you agreed you would pick on Natamari.
Yukimi, it's part of my strategy to win. I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to tell you. Hang tight for a bit. If you say so, let's move on. Next player. Oh.
Mary.
Job, everybody! All of our players have finally finished turning in their confession cards. All that's left now is the results.
The result.
I've done everything that I can.
Oh my God!
With this plan, we should be able to win.
I have your table's results. The order will be.
Yes! We got confession order. And if it's okay, I want last.
That'll be fine. Let's just get it done. That won't be a problem. The first confessor, Kurumi Kurume. Her confession was made to Kibashira. Our results? We have a couple.
Ah, oh, crap. I got it, right?
Hmm? We hoping to have a chance at the money? That's cool. I'd still be down for going on a real date with you.
Please leave courting until later. Our next confession was from Togakushi and was delivered to Musubi. Another successful couple.
No!
I also have strong opinions about literature. We will get along great. You wagered a dinner date, have I got that right? We'll find us somewhere romantic and make a reservation.
This can't be a coincidence. What is the likelihood we'd have two couples in a row? So that means we really do have a traitor here.
Yeah.
Kurume and Yukimi aren't off the hook because they got paired up. The traitor would try to cover their tracks by giving themselves a match too. I'm glad I planned that countermeasure with Suzura. Next up, Hanatemari. We have another couple. Huh? Followed by Saotome, who made another couple. Last is Inui, another happy couple. Congratulations, we have five couples.
No
Such
way.
An accomplishment. Enjoy, ladies.
I don't understand.
Oh my gosh!
We agreed! Well, this didn't play out like we thought.
What the hell? This is bullshit! I refuse to accept this at all!
Calm yourself. Is there something you're trying to imply here?
Of course there is! How could there be five couples at one table? Suzura and I swapped our choices before we even made the confessions. We wanted to protect ourselves in case someone shared our picks with the guys. It isn't possible to have this many matches unless someone cheated.
I will not tolerate accusations.
I caught you cheating just the other
What's
day!
What's wrong, Mary? Is there a problem I can help you with? Sachiko Jirok! Is she the one behind this?
Yeah, there is! I'm calling out for Ski
Dog! I won't stand here and listen to any more of your accusations. No house staff has altered your results. I can guarantee you that with the utmost confidence.
Do you really expect me to believe that?
Oh my God!
Mary, don't be blinded by your own failure. There's another way. A completely different, much simpler possibility. Was there something I missed? Even if we did end up getting betrayed by someone, there was no way that everyone would still become paired up. The only thing that makes sense is that management cheated. No, I refuse to believe that. There's no way that can be right. The traitor is Suzura.
Oh.
If management is telling the truth and they didn't cheat, then it would make total sense. Suzura was the only one that knew our confessions were going to be different. Why was Suzura having that meeting with Mibuomi before I got there? What were they talking about? Maybe they're working together to entrap me for standing up against the student council, and she worked out some sort of sweetheart deal for herself? But wouldn't that mean Yukimi was in on it, too? Of course Jiraka would be in on it. I bet they're all working together to bring me down.
Well done. That will conclude the first round. Now it's time to get started with the bonus game. Begin round two. Value will be doubled at 2 million yen.
Okay.
Now then, what are you going to do?
Oh, I gave you so much money and you just lost it all. You know you're going to be a husband at this rate, right?
But I don't have 2 million yen.
You don't need that much. No worries, girl. Karumi's got you. But I can only do 20,000 each.
sleepover to your wager.
This is going to be so much more fun.
What a great idea.
Do you like that option? What do you say, Mary?
Mary, no!
Shut up. I don't want anyone else to talk to me. No more. I'm so sick of being conned by these people. What should I do? What can I do?
We'll open up second round registration for the next 10 minutes. To anyone that might be interested, please come by the registration desk.
If I found myself in your position, I'd participate in a heartbeat. If you do nothing aside from stand there, you're doomed to become a house pet. You have 10 minutes left. Think carefully about your next move.
So for this anime of the Mary's story is crazy.
Yeah.
Before season one. This anime is dope.
Mary.
I'm not gonna play in the second round.
What?
I'm dropping out.
Oh.
I'm done.
Good. You gotta do the fake cam, okay?
Hello.
We're back.
Mary, can I play a second round?
You were sitting out the next
round.
What about the donation money we owe?
I haven't gotten myself in too much debt. I can ask my parents if I can borrow some money to try and get through this. I just hope they don't have an issue with that.
But what about later? You said we need cash on hand to make money. So how are we supposed to do that?
Don't know.
Wait, you said... You told me that the two of us were going to be winners. If you're not going to gamble, then how do we win this? If you walk away, what's going to happen to the den? You'll lose everything we've been working so hard for.
Mary.
Sorry, but you guys really need to stop depending on me. The two of you got along fine without me before, right? Yukini, you were able to pay the donations on your own. And Suzura, your family is wealthy. I can't help you out anymore, but if you're in that bad of a spot, maybe you should ask Musubi. He seems to really fancy you, too.
What? What are you talking about? You're so mean you made her cry!
No, Mary! What do you want?
I do not know how the results ended up the way that they did today, so I can't say sorry. But you, Mary, I thought I knew would never give up because of this. If she thought she was betrayed, she wouldn't walk away. You are so smart. You're strong, and you put your all into everything you do. You never give up. You always turn it around and win. I know this better than anyone, and I know you, Mary. This isn't you.
God, that makes me cringe. I put in my all? Yeah, well, if you hadn't betrayed me, then we would have won. There had to have been a traitor. There's another way. A completely different, much simpler possibility.
So, what do you think you'll end up doing?
Huh?
The second round, there's less than 5 minutes left to register.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah. You're right. I'll have to trust Suzura.
Huh?
I'll play in the second round.
Do you mean that?
Yep.
Suzura, thanks for that. I'm thinking more clearly now.
It's okay. I just really...
It wouldn't be a good idea for me to let you lose if you did betray me. I want to be the one that beats you down.
What? Hey, do you even know what you're saying?
They're fighting.
I want the three of you to play in the second round, too.
I'm definitely in. There's no way a
I'd miss out on something fun like this.
Oh, my God.
I don't know what I should do.
Well, if you want to, you can quit now. But if you ask me, it's a waste not to play.
Huh?
We're definitely going to win. Come with me. I'll explain while we walk. But, I don't want you around when I do.
Wait, what? What's that supposed to mean?
What's going on? I'm not sure, but I think what happened. I'm not sure too.
Another simple strategy this time. We'll all pick a different guy to confess to, just like we did before.
Huh? So what would stop us from losing this time around?
We lost the last game because Suzura betrayed us and told the guys who we were confessing to. So let's do the same thing again, but this time we'll leave Suzura out. Even with the four of us, this strategy is still pretty effective.
But even if she doesn't know who we're going to pick, wouldn't Hanate Mari still try to pair herself up with someone anyway? I think there's a rule that would make the second confessor lose if she gets to him first.
I wouldn't worry. Even if that did happen, we'd still probably only end up with one couple. It's pretty unlikely that out of the other three couples, we'd end up with more than one. Even if something were to interfere with those couplings, we still have an advantage from whatever benefit we want to declare. So regardless of what happens, we can still end up winning.
What are we winning, though? You're talking about money, right? Because these benefits, I don't want to have to sleep with someone that I don't know. I would rather die. I'm sorry, Mary. I need to find someone else for this team.
I'd prefer it if we didn't change anyone out. If the person they swapped you with ended up being a plant by the guys, it'd be a disaster. Yukimi, you care about that gambling den just as much as we do. If you give up now, you give up everything. You have to take on risk to get what you want. Isn't that the core of what gambling is? Here, I'm giving you the gambling den. This should be enough to prove it. Transfer request should at least let you keep the den even if you lose, right?
Fine. I guess I'll play again.
Okay, what about you two?
Oh, I'm in. Let's get this done. We've come this far, so I'll see you through until the end.
Do you know where I can get a lineup card?
I have one. It's an extra from before.
Let me take care of the details. I already know what we should do. I have a plan.
Okay.
Take a look and remember your picks.
I have to pick Musubi again?
Why these couples specifically?
That's a secret.
Wait a minute, if we're going to be on the same team, shouldn't we at least know why?
This is amusing. So Tomi may be saying Hanate Mori is the traitor.
But in reality,
I don't think she trusts anybody here. I assume that's why she put herself last, since it's the safest position. It allows her to avoid doubling up with anyone. She sensed her power within the group and naturally made herself our leader.
What a fiendishly clever woman.
This is fun.
I have a high suspicion about her.
To register, so please get those cards in.
I have been
following your lead. Have any ideas for round two, Chief?
I don't. I think I might be done, guys. I don't see the point. Hanate Mari doesn't seem like she likes me. And I don't think Tokukushi likes me either. I don't stand a chance. Even if I did take her to dinner, I don't think things would change. Ugh, why did I ever care about this stupid game? Besides, it's not like we can just do the same thing again.
Well, I can't argue with that, but...
So maybe we should just call it quits for today.
Hey, what are you doing, Haruto? This is a game we're guaranteed to win if we play. Stopping at 330,000 isn't enough for me. Hey, you don't need to convince me. Then maybe you should be putting in a little more effort. Even if we do end up losing, this Patsy's gonna cover her entrance fees.
Looks like good news is on the way.
Alright, you guys. I just found out who the girls are confessing to.
Huh? Oh, hell yeah. So?
They finished talking it over, and our friend let me know who everyone's gonna pick.
Sweet, that's lucky. Chief, let's get in on this next round.
Money wasn't really the reason I was playing this.
I heard something that might interest you. You know Togekushi? She's picking you. She wants to offer a sleepover.
You sure about that?
Sounds like good news for you, Chief. So if you play the next round, you definitely get some.
Oh shit. God damn, he's so fucking weird. Alright guys, round two.
Let's get started. This is the final round, so prepare yourselves. Are you ready? Let's get coupling. Round two begins now.
Alright.
Does everybody remember the plan? I don't want any surprises.
Got it. Is it a good idea for us to talk about it right here?
It's fine. This game will be ours to take. We were destined to become winners. Very well. Are there any benefits to declare?
I'm not afraid of risking anything to win. Sleep over, please.
Anyone else?
Yeah, me too.
Two participants for sleepover. Yes?
I wanna...
If you're serious about wanting to be a winner, then you should be taking the biggest risk. But you know, I guess none of that would matter to a traitor, would it?
I'll do it! I'll offer a sleepover!
So three sleepovers.
This is getting tense. Y'all are freaking horny.
Thank you, noted. Please begin the next round.
And Chief, I know Hanatomari is the girl you like better, but if you choose to recruit her, you'll probably be able to get to third base. Just think about this.
Yeah, I'm trying to, man.
I was surprised when she wanted us to play again. Hard to believe you'd get different results from the same members, really. Does Saotome have some sort of vendetta against Jirako and the student council? But the worst case scenario didn't happen. Saotome abandoned Hanatomari for betraying her trust, so... It makes sense to share who we'll confess to among the four of us, without Hanatomari. But unfortunately for Mary, that plan is already a bust. You know why? Because I'm the one who betrayed them!
I knew it!
I knew it!
Make my choice.
Musubi is the heir to a filthy rich corporate CEO. He and his four little doggies beg me to help them get some girls in return for some cash. Musubi is rich, but money doesn't make up for who he is. He's obsessed with women who present themselves with stereotypical ideas of femininity. He's playing the game to take advantage of the benefits. To be honest, he really kind of makes my skin crawl. Well, it's not like I have to deal with him, so I'm just gonna keep focusing on getting paid. I mean, wouldn't it be a waste to claw my way into this school and not make any money once I got here? Sorry for selling you out. I hope you enjoy those benefits. Which of you would like to start?
Oh, right. I did nothing to Sarah. But just for this round, I'm doing this for the sake of the game. Won't you still be the only man that has my heart?
Great. Next confession. Go ahead.
Oh, that would be me.
So, let's just see here. The guys paid me real well to know who's confessing to whom. Other than Hanatomari, everyone else is practically guaranteed to become a couple. Those idiots would probably suspect me if I didn't pair up with someone, too. Your confession, Kurume.
Boom! I confess to Kuonji right now!
Oh!
Are you sure, Kurume? What happened to us all following the plan? Why would I worry about that?
Didn't Mary tell us flat out one of us was a traitor? It wouldn't make much sense to follow the plan now, would it?
I guess not. Don't give me that look! It's not my fault!
Next person.
Me next. I gotta make my choice.
Togakushi followed during the first round. She should stick with the plan.
The road has been long. Looking back, all 17 years of my life have been filled with rejection from girls. I'd tell them my feelings and get shot down. Sometimes they wouldn't even talk to me because I creeped them out.
Yeah, you're fucking weird.
But all of that is coming to an end.
Today I become a man!
Are you ready? I need your confession.
Yes.
I'll win this game and sleep over!
I can't wait to get paid!
Oh, I'm making my confession now.
This is it! I win!
I'm choosing Kibashira.
Yes!
Yeah!
Or me!
What? Not possible! Is Togakushi betraying Saotome too?
You two are done!
Next confession, please.
That's me!
Damn it, what the hell is going on? This cow gave up on Hanate Mari and chose Togakushi to be safe! If they don't pair up, we're gonna walk away from this with empty pockets!
Hanate Mari?
Oh, here goes nothing. I think I'm gonna pick... I confess to Musubi!
Musubi made it pretty freaking clear that he was into Hanate Mari first round! Why would she take such a big risk by picking him?
Musubi? I didn't realize you were such a popular guy. I think I might be jealous. Because I'm madly in love with you, too.
Oh, my face!
That's great!
Thank you. This concludes round two of the coupling game. There's only been one successful pairing at the stable. Congratulations to Inui and Sarah. Best wishes for you both.
This can't be. I did. You're even more stupid than I thought.
Yep.
Inui, your little game to the Trenix wasn't as clever as you hoped.
That's not the truth. I didn't do anything.
Come on. You don't need to play dumb anymore. I have been keeping a close eye on everything you've done. In the first round, Suzura was the only person who knew who I was confessing to. But somehow, everyone still got coupled up anyway. That really threw me off. The only logical conclusion was that Suzura had snuck to our choices. But there was something about it that didn't add up. Suzura would never betray me. Everything else started falling into place when I remembered that.
Oh, Mary.
Honestly, it was easy to tell something was off right from the start. I'm sure I wasn't the only one who noticed that the dealer never said any of our names out loud during the game. Next person, please. Next lady, please. Next player. So I started going back through all the events of the day in my head, and that's when I remembered something. Specifically, the use of the lineup cards.
The lineup cards?
Think about it. In the first round, all of us sat at the table in the order we'd written down on that card. And that corresponded to when we needed to make our confessions, too, because we all assumed our names were in the order we'd all agreed on. But hear me out. What if whoever wrote the order of our names on the lineup card had actually slid them one position forward?
Hang on a second. So even if we were confessing in our seated order, the number assigned to the confessor on the chart belonged to someone else. So before we got to say who we were picking, those cheaters would have already seen the card and known who we were confessing to.
Shiraku told us.
No house staff has altered your results.
The house didn't cheat, but that doesn't mean they didn't endorse who did. The dealer would have seen it coming. To the rest of us, it wouldn't have been as obvious. The con fell apart once that piece of the puzzle fell into place. One person would have that opportunity, and Inui had volunteered to submit the lineup card. But you know what they say about hindsight being 20-20. So I wrote everything down myself the second round. I didn't want to give Inui another chance.
Well played. But Inui wouldn't have used the same trick twice. The second round was a much simpler con, wasn't it? Signaling. You can use your smartphone or body tells. It doesn't matter which, really. Getting the correct information communicated discreetly to the man is difficult. So tell me, Mary, how did you overcome these circumstances?
You don't know? I think that was the easiest part. It wasn't a con. I just never really doubted these three. I hadn't met Karume before, so I had every reason to suspect her of being the traitor. We never had a chance to establish mutual trust. So I decided to roll with that. If she was the traitor, I could gamble that. And if she wasn't, she could assume I was. I just banked on the fact that she was an unstable element. I mean, we've never interacted with each other before. With that said, I figured she would probably change up her answer at the last minute. She has absolutely no reason to trust me. So I just trusted in that.
Well, aren't you clever? So it was lucky that I changed my mind.
When it came to Yukimi, I signaled a plan in writing. I had to trust that she had my best interest at heart, and that if I needed her to do something, she would most likely pull it off.
No way! The transfer!
Yep. I left her a clue when I wrote down our transfer.
If you weren't paying attention, my show of giving her the rights to the den must have been pretty convincing. But the name of the den that I wrote was a fake one, not the one that we use.
I tried to consider all the reasons why Santome would do something like that. And I chose to believe that it was a message to me that she was putting on an act. So I decided to change who I was confessing to.
What about Hanate Mari, then? She didn't have a chance to hear any of our plan! I was feeling so alone and confused. But I always end up being the problem eventually, so I figured this was just how it would end. I needed Mari to remind me about the promise we made together.
This game will be ours to take. We were destined to become winners.
She's amazing. Mari risked so much to send the message. But that's what you have to do if you want to win. Today, I made sure I only took time to speak with Musubi. It was obvious that choosing Musubi posed the greatest risk to me of being paired up. I didn't care. That was the gamble I made.
What? I don't get this at all! Look, it's such a fake brand of references! What kind of relationship do you two have that makes this possible?
Sorry, but you lost.
It's funny you can't guess.
Game over.
Game over.
Mari is my Prince Charming.
Wraps it up. Long story short, I saw right through your little setup and you all walked into my trap. You said the wager was doubled this time around, right? I should thank you and your colleagues. You were easy to beat.
Now I have so much money!
Thank you, boys.
Say that again!
Can you please stop provoking them when we're about to close? We don't have time to deal with anger. Your wagers will be collected by the Beautification and Makeover Committee and delivered promptly to you. The benefits are at your discretion. If they are not executed, please contact us. Table 3 is now complete.
Okay! The final table has turned in their confessions! That about wraps up everything we have on the schedule! We hope you had a great time at today's coupling party! The results from this event are always wildly different from group to group, but whether you leave here today alone or with a partner, we always try to make sure we have fun. Thanks so much.
Love it, Dave.
Annual coupling party is now officially over. We hope to see you singles on the 51st one. Take care, everybody.
Damn.
She made a 2 million comeback in the second round. Fantastic. I knew she could pull it off.
You're going to let her join?
Yeah, that's okay, right? Something tells me we'll want to keep Mari real close to the chest. For our plan to work, she's necessary.
Wow, I wasn't sure how that was going to play out. Yeah, you're so right.
Oh, Mari.
I couldn't have done it without Mari.
Hey, you guys. Please forgive me.
Whoa, wait, what's wrong?
I questioned your integrity when it really mattered. The two of you didn't do anything to deserve that. I'm sorry.
What? No, don't worry about it. No one could blame you after the con they tried to pull. And hey, it all worked out in the end, so let's consider it.
Whoa.
I was scared. I keep feeling like I've been holding you back from being your best. I thought you wanted to get rid of me.
You taught me something very important today. It's important to believe in the people around me. Yeah, I know it sounds really cheesy, but we only won because I knew the two of you would have my back. And you guys knew me well enough to trust that I would never leave you behind.
Oh, come on, I'm blushing.
Thank you so much for believing in me. Let's make a promise. We'll never let anyone get between the three of us again.
Yeah.
We got this.
Ooh. There's dinner.
Yeah, three of them.
This shit is so good.
Looking hungry, Kabe.
This
is just
chilling. Yep.
Let's see, boy.
And it's your girl. This is just silent eating without any saying any. Alright, guys, so here's the thing. So we had to cut out, right? But also we were like sent back to where we left before this shit happened. At a counter, my dad was home. He was having a massive headache, and it said that we were like a SWAT room, right? Mm-hmm. This is, of course, where we're at. It's coming in the dining room, and this is the dining room. So, of course, we're continuing what I thought. You know what to say. What the show must go on. So while my dad's just relaxing, while he had a headache, right? We're of course going to continue as Category Twin, which we're gonna watch at episode 5. But this is where we left off before we were interrupted. But guys, back to the character, because now we're gonna watch Category Twin. So where we left off.
And then after that, now for Category Twin and Liquid Day Meal over 8 and then Triple A.
Alright, click Donna.
Alright, let's do it. I'm so excited.
Oh my god.
So the real game is to fight for the box.
Yeah.
So guys, we do know the next anime is coming up, it's Liquid Day Meal. But before we go to Liquid Day Meal, we're gonna watch another episode of Category Twin.
Yeah, so I think where's the you see the D bar on the top?
Yeah.
Alright. Cricket?
Alright.
Okay. Alright. Oh, right here. Alright, hold on. So, guys, next up, we're gonna watch the last episode of Category Twin. Guys, this was the Mary best side character. This is, of course, a best backstory from we just saw the anime. One of the best backstory. This is, of course, we get to fully see of Mary before Yumiko show up on season 1. Which we're gonna see her again on season 2, but season 2 will be announced after the last episode, like I promised. So, guys, we're gonna watch the last episode of Category Twin. So, guys,
and now episode 6 of Category Twin starts
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Filled by Subway and WrestleMania 40. Let's do it.
Careful, Mary!
No way. Oh, this is it.
Very well. Well done, all. Let's play your final match in a setting that's more appropriate. Of course, you will gamble.
I go to win. I gotta say, this anime right here is honestly the best, right? There wasn't a lot of topic because what's important about this anime is that they're gonna explain the rule. Like remember the second point I said? We cannot talk a lot because they had to explain the rule, the strategy, or what the fuck is going on. So they were explaining to us.
Yeah, they're playing the game. Alright guys,
so here's the thing. You know that category is coming, because the new category season 2 is coming, right? And so, you may wonder, when the category season 2 is coming? Well, it's going to come out in the second course, but not only that, it's going to be part of the channel I'm watching on, Double or Nothing. And this is the perfect way for us to watch season 2, is because of being a Double or Nothing, Casino, Gambler, all that shit, right? Category season 2 is the perfect thing to have it. You guys, of course, there's not one song, there was nothing coming, nothing has announced yet, but it will also be coming, so there was nothing. So make sure you look forward to seeing more info on our social media platform, whatever you follow at our Instagram. So, guys, like I said, Category Twin was actually the best one, and we're gonna see Mary backstory. I really hope that we can see them again. For season 2, that's side Mary. So guys, we know that season 2 is gonna be a lot more. Okay, so hopefully we'll see Yumiko. We definitely see Yumiko because this is where we learn a lot of stuff. Okay, so then we see you guys on a little bit of the game. Clue for day 5. I want it now. Give me your.